Hi there, I'm Bruce Ian Miller, and today I would like to present to you something. It's like a poem, it's like a song, but without being either one. And there's a background to this. I grew up in a family that did not have a car, and I liked flying model airplanes. In my early teens, I would go out to the Ellerslie Flying Field, 9 miles into the country, on my bicycle carrying my model airplane. And anyways, misfortune followed and I was depressed. I went to Alberta Hospital a number of times. And when I was in the hospital, everything's so clean and sterile. It's maddening. I wanted to be outside again. And that was the, that's why I wrote this little piece. It's about my experience in biking. Roads I can remember changed places at night, and undimmed headlights are still passing by, with semi-trucks and smaller shapes still coming from behind. I need to trust the fire kept in your taillight. Now look to the daylight, dirt on steel, dew on trees. Talk cannot describe the outside of what's inside of me. It's the swing of the cranks, the sweep of my time, the scatter of the gravel, and everything besides, the land that begot me, coming back to mind. I want to see your face, long grades, blowing rains, golden stubble and scattered things, brought together by the line, like the lines on the lakes and the breeze blowing by. Part of me is drawn out by the outsides. It's the swing of the cranks, the sweep of my time, the scatter of the gravel, and everything besides, the land that begot me, kindred and kind. Supple and steering, downhill and downwind, in the slip she is spinning, and around goes my life. Looked at crossings, back, forward, and besides, the shiftings of the compass, the quietness of the mind. It's the swing of the cranks, the sweep of my time, the scatter of the gravel, and everything besides, the land that begot me, governing my stride. Half centuries add together, like green water in the ditches, and ducks stammering to the miracle of flight. Two bikes were stolen, the first two used parts. I lost something to see you. Now don't you leave me. It's the swing of the cranks, the sweep of my time, the scatter of the gravel, and everything besides, all the getting to you that I long to recognize. Now, there are a lot of figures of speech in here that might not be understood by everyone. So I'm going to give you a short explanation of most of them. Valence, the title, is the old chemistry term for the combining power of the elements. And this song is very elemental. The wind and the rain, the subscript to the title, is in the Bible,
that's what comes before the harvest. And this poem does something for me. The first part, I used to go out riding in the country, and I would do century rides, which in bicycling lore is riding a bicycle out and back for a total of 100 miles a day. And what it meant is that I'd go out during the day, and very often when I came back, it was at night. And that's where the poem starts, you know? And anyways, this is something that I recommend that you don't try unless you're planning to do it safely. You need reflective clothing and a good light on the bike. I replaced the manufacturer's lightweight hookup wire with 16 gauge automobile wire, and it makes the lights burn very bright. Now, the second part, now look to the daylight. When I wrote this, I had an image in my mind of going out on my bike on a damp morning, past the guardrails at the side of the road, and seeing a stand of spruce trees a little bit further back. And there's more to it than that. To me, you know, dirt and steel are not the same, but steel is made from heating up iron ore, which is dirt. And there's a relationship to me. And similarly, the trees need, and so dew and trees are not the same, but I see a relationship. And all the getting, and you know, talk cannot describe the outside of what's inside of me. You know, in my heart, in my soul, I feel things sometimes that I can't express. And that's what that's about. Now, the chorus, it's the swing of the cranks. I'm referring to the crank wheel that you pedal with your feet. And as you ride, it goes swinging back and forth. And the sweep of my time, I'm thinking of a wall clock with three RNs, one of them being a second hand. And the time that I'm riding is just going by, like the time of the clock. And the gravel, the scatter of the gravel, well, I liked going down country roads and everything besides. I go down, I see a lot of things, but I can't list them all. So I just say besides everything, besides to mean everything I see. The land that begot me, coming back to mind, was actually borrowed from a poem called Scotland, which had a chorus with the land that begot me, defying the plough. And I sort of like that. Now, I want to see your face. Was the face the land? And later on, as I revised this, I would think it was the face of a girl that I was going to see. Now, the line in the last part of this verse is the title of a painting that I saw at the Edmonton Public Art Gallery. And it's a picture of a rural scene seen from a moving vehicle. Now, the lines on the lakes are the waves. And when the wind comes, there are waves. And when I'm outside for a while, I am come out of myself, like the waves do of this water. Okay. And in the chorus, the last line is the land that begot kindred and kind. Because I felt at home being outside. now supple and steering downhill and downwind. That was, you know, I liked the bike. I liked the feeling of going and being narrow. And my life revolves when I'm out riding for the day. Now, when I'm out riding, you know, looked at crossings back forwards and besides. You know, in the city, you go and there's crossroads. You have to be kind of alert. But going out in the country, I feel very calm in making turns. Sometimes I would go out for turns that I never knew what was going on. And the shiftings of the compass, well, I would turn. Bikes don't have compasses, but ships do on the ocean. And this 100-mile bike ride I'm comparing it to a voyage. And the quietness of the mind, you know, I was turning a corner and I feel calm, quiet and confident. That's the way I would have liked my life to be when I make decisions, calm and confident. And the land that begot me governing my stride. Well, when you're in a car, and I did have a driver's license, so I know, you press the accelerator and that decides, or the brake and that decides how fast and how far you're going. But with the bike, you have to work with the wind, whether it's going against you or with you. You have to go up and down the hills, and the land controls you more than you control the land. And that's why I said governing my stride. Now, again, half centuries add together. Well, 50 miles plus 50 miles. You know, you go out and you start out perky and frisky, and you go home rock steady, solid, and slow. And anyways, I said I like going in country roads. And sometimes in the spring, I'd be going down a road and there'd be water in the ditches. And I'd be going along and then the ducks would hear me coming and they'd go stammering to flight. And, you know, from model airplanes, I knew a lot about flight, but I would forget that and just enjoy seeing those ducks. And two bikes were stolen, you know, over my lifetime. But I got my first 10-speed when I was in grade 8 in school. And that's when I bet the new pair of handlebars to cradle my airplanes on when I was going out to the flying field. And anyways, I wore it out. You know, I had a whole bag of used brake pads, for example. And two bikes were stolen. There's a 12-speed and an 18-speed bike, and they were lost. And anyways, you know, but I didn't stop. I just bought myself another bike. And anyways, I love all of the getting to you, I long to recognize. Well, that was from being locked up in a room. You know, that isn't where my heart was. I wanted to be out in the country on my bike. However, when I was about 40 years old, I went legally blind. So I wasn't able to do any more biking. So anyways, this is just a bit of a story. Thank you for listening, and bye for now.